Welcome and good afternoon from the heart of hydraulics here in Lohr am Main, and welcome to the June edition of our Connected Hydraulics webinar concerning optimized performance of axial piston pumps. With me, I have the expert from Horb am Neckar, Markus Eisel, and we will give you a lot of information about how you can increase the performance, especially the speed, by axial piston pumps. But before we go into the details, I would like to explain to you a little bit how this works. I assume some of you have been here already, but let's explain it for the people that are new. So this is an interactive webinar. You see the picture from ourselves, the live picture. You should hear us. If not, it's a problem with your computer, unfortunately, not with us. To your left side, you see the content that Markus has prepared, and during the webinar you will be able to give us your feedback, your comments in the chat section below. But we also have prepared some questions for you to make it even more interactive, and that's also how I would like to start now, with a question to you now. So first question to you, to get used to this poll: are you a manufacturer or a machine user? So please click the answers. We have about 100 participants, so feel free to give us your where you're coming from. And I assume most of you come from the Americas, from Northern or Southern America, so I hope everything is good with you. You see, we also keep the distance here, even if in Germany a COVID situation is not so bad like in other countries, but of course we take it very seriously, and we hope you are all well and we get to the situation safe. So we still only have about 30 clicks from about 100 people, so please, I would like to urge you again to give us your information, what kind of participant we have. Okay, so it looks like broad range. We have customers, yes. End customers, we have machine manufacturers, we have some employees from Rexroth and partners. So welcome to all of you. I see Turkey, Spain, Brazil, Portugal. Nice to have again a global team. Second question, a little more close to where you're coming from. Is it the machine tools, the presses, the plastic machines? What kind of business sector are you coming from? If not, if you have clicked others, please write down in the chat section a little more on details. This morning we had a lot of people from the marine also. Let's see where the others coming from. Otherwise, it's kind of the same picture: the presses, the metallurgy, the bigger, I would say, applications. But let's see, cement industry, FL Smith, this is a partner, I would say. Marine, oil and gas, marine, okay. And then the last question for the warm-up: what is your personal role inside the company? So we'd like to understand if you are from the design department, the research and development, if it's a sales role that you have, or if you're from service or maintenance. So this could help us maybe also to focus on your individual views. So lots of salespeople, I would say, from the internals and from the partners, but also design and service maintenance. We will leave this open for some more seconds, so to give you the chance to vote. But I would say now it's a good time to switch to you, Markus. Optimizing the performance with these products, kind of products. Well, the product itself, it's not a complete newbie. We have it since several decades, some of these. But what is the real, let's say, special thing you're talking about today?
Okay, so hello also from my side. My name is Markus Eisel. I'm located in Horb am Neckar, and I'm part of the product sales and product management of these nice axial piston pumps. So what we are talking about today, the main topic is, well, increasing the speed of these pumps, which means at the end more flow. And also talking about speed control, which means we get a new degree of freedom. And this means smaller pumps, less pumps in the machine, and at the end of the day, saving money. So what will we see today? So we will see how to increase the speed. We take as an example the relatively well-known A4 VSO. You will have a short glance at the electrohydraulic pump and speed control. And we will also see, and this is why this product is here, the benefits of an integrated boost pump, a 15 VLO, and not to miss, we will have some application examples here. Mm-hmm. And well, and quite important question, noise effects on operating data.
Okay. So this is the overview about the webinar today. We will have about 30 minutes of content and then we will go to your questions. So feel free to place your questions during the webinar. We try to answer them if they're fitting into the moment, but otherwise at the end we will answer them. And if it's too much for us, we don't care. We also will answer these questions in a written form and we will send it to you with the handout of the documentation. So starting maybe with the portfolio, giving us some information here.
So well, this is the overview. So as you see, in general, we are well prepared for pumps with speed control, depending on the operating data. On the left side, you find our well-known A10Z program, which is specially designed for cytronics applications, but also with the bigger pumps, such as A15, or even A4 VBO for high pressure, and at the end A4 VSO, where I will show how we can increase the speed in operation.
So now my question would be, this is kind of a broad portfolio. What would you say is the most used product, maybe based on the requirements from our customers? Or we can ask our customers.
Yeah, we should ask maybe our customers.
So next question to you. What are usually the maximum flow rates of your hydraulic pump system? Is it below 100 liters, between 100 and 400, or even more? Yeah, and let's say, looking at this, I think it's covering what we have expected in the discussion in the preparation phase. So you said to me it's basically in between 100 and 400 liters. So looking at your portfolio, it looks like you're quite set here, quite well set. Okay, polls are coming in, but it looks like a clear picture. And then I think there was a follow-up question to this. Question five,
No.
Question five is coming later. So yeah, go into the benefits, how to increase the speed.
Okay, so coming to A4 VSO, we have a concept of two different kinds of rotary groups. One is the standard rotary group, and the other one, the redly highlighted, is the high-speed rotary group. What does it mean? You see it in the highlighted size 250 as an example. So the standard one can make 1500 RPM at full stroke, and the high speed can reach 1900 RPM, which means in the same ratio, more flow.
And I see a nice star over there with a smaller size pump that even can reach more speed. Can you tell us a little bit about this?
Yeah. The star is for the size 71, which is relatively new in our program. And this pump can reach up to 3000 RPM. So this means you get out of it 213 liters per minute, which is quite a lot for such a relatively small pump. And not to forget, coming soon there will be a size 180. The final speed we are under evaluation at the moment. There are some tests that should be made, but as soon as it is available, it will be announced, of course.
So now we learned a little bit about the product and the differences in the increasement. So maybe an application example. We also promised to have some application examples here.
Of course. So exactly for this high-speed A4 VSO 71, I have a nice application example. So it comes from the plastics industry, and it replaces basically, for example, the fixed internal gear pumps, mm-hmm. or also our A10 VSO. And the benefit of the customer is he gets a significantly smaller pump or less pumps, and with the much higher turning speed and a variable pump at variable speed, he saves so much energy and money that it compensates or overcompensates even the extra cost for the pumps. Mm-hmm. So it's a quite big benefit. And till now we have high quantities in the field, and the beginning or the start of the size 71 in high speed was made from customer side in this way, and so it.
I see the nice innovation award here. So yeah, I think it's an internal award, as far as I know.
It's an internal award, but anyway, our design department is quite proud of it.
Okay. Yeah, I think we are coming to the size of this company and the many people in engineering we have. I think that's a very outstanding achievement over there. Okay, now talking from the application example, I think you go a little more detail more detail.
So we will come now to some practical more. Mm-hmm. So we have A for VSO, and now how to increase the speed. Mm-hmm. So you have, we show it in the example with the high speed 250, so the nominal speed in general is 1900. There's you find in the data sheet a second number, which is 2100. Under certain conditions, you can do that. And these certain conditions are described in this graph on the right side, which is also in the data sheet. So how it works? First of all, we need to determine the speed factor. Mm-hmm. So this means in our case, we want to run by 2100 full stroke, full quantity, and this means the speed factor will be 1.1, so the 2100 to 1900. So you go into the diagram on the left side, and then you go straight to the right, and then you find the inlet pressure, which means 1.4 bar in absolute. So this means 0.4 bar roughly more than standard. And with these conditions, you can run these 2100 RPM. And this means with this
25%,
pump,
25%, wow.
This means with this kind of pump, 525 liters, which is quite a lot.
Okay. But there's a second option, I think?
Yes, there's a second option. For our topic, it is not that important. The second option means you reduce the displacement of the pump, and then you can go up with the speed. Mm-hmm. But as you can see, so it's the same kind of how to do it. So you determine the speed factor, and then you search the 1 bar line normally for the inlet pressure, and you go down and find the factor for the displacement. And you find out, well, 325 liters at 1800 RPM for the standard rotary group. Mm-hmm. This is more if the question is, well, I have a machine in Europe, I pass it to America, and well, ooh, the turning speed is 1800 okay. Now, what shall I do?
Okay. I think no questions up to now. So feel free to give us your questions if you have some. I think I've already shown a lot of information, but there will come more. But before we go into more information, there's a next question prepared for you. So what is particularly important to you when using a pump speed control? Once, if you haven't used it, of course, that's the first one, but you can choose from these options. That's a multiple choice question, so you can give us several examples or several answers. So what is the most, how relevant is the pump speed control? So saving energy, of mm-hmm. course, that's one of the biggest issues, and then, but also the size, using smaller, less pumps. Mm-hmm. The noise emission is coming up a little bit, so you promised to talk about this in the end, but basically, yeah, it's saving the energy, and it's directly cost related, I would say. Okay, and then following up these questions, there's another one, and the last one for you now. If you have not used the speed control so far, so what would be the reasons? Please, especially the guys who have clicked on the first answer, give us your feedback here, if it's concerning the hardware costs or the efforts or the know-how issue. But I think it was not so many people that hasn't chosen this answer right now. So let's see. Extra efforts for automation, lack of know-how. Sometimes the application is not suitable. Okay, I think that's helpful information for you. So I'll go even more into some details now.
Okay. So when talking about speed increase, speed control, we are very fast at electrohydraulic pump controls, which are very well prepared for that. So I will explain that with the example of the HS5, which you see here. So the system itself consists of four items. This is the general rule. So it's the basic pump. It is the control valve. We have a swivel angle sensor. And at the end, we have a control electronics, and which will be fed by third party. So HS5 is available for all A4 pump models and up to 630 bar even. We have a version for under oil, and we have also a version which is fed by internal pilot pressure.
Okay. And the HS5N, you said intelligent speed control. Could you go into a little more detail about this, please?
Yes, the N is the sign for us for speed control. I explain it on the next slide. So HS5 can be easily upgraded from standard HS5 with constant speed to a speed variable controller, just with the SD card. Even later on, this can be also interesting for retrofits. And you just need a frequency converter for your motor then, and now the controller will fix the values for the speed of the motor and also the swivel angle according to the flow which is required.
Okay. Thank you.
So not to forget HS5E. This is the version of HS5 with onboard electronics. This means everything what you have seen and what would have been placed into a switch cabinet, the small box with the controller, is on the pump itself. It is completely wired and pre-parameterized. So you save the switch cabinet, and you also avoid some normal commissioning mistakes, which happen regularly. It's also available for all A4 pumps. So this is another option which can be used.
Okay.
And not to forget, there will also be a N version, which means speed control. So we will bring it to the market very soon. The same functionality as a HS5N, which means speed control, flow effects, and best efficiency.
So again, application example. This is from Japan. I like this example because it's a quite big one, and we have people from the applications. So I think here, again, energy saving. Can you tell us a little bit about this application?
Yes. So this is a project we made with our Japanese colleagues. So I like also very much the real examples. So we created a drive for scrap shear with servo drives, and they made real measurements, and at the end of the day they gained some energy saving of around 30%, which is quite a lot here. So you have 5 to 6 pumps in this machine, so you can imagine.
Since when do you have this application running?
So it's running since a few years already.
Okay. By Kawasaki as a competitor,
but not yeah. Well, here. this is normal in especially in Asian countries.
Yeah. Okay, Well, 30% is really, really,
this is
really
quite a lot, and in absolutely, I don't know, but this is really a lot of energy.
Thanks for this insight. Now coming to this one here, so the A15.
Yes.
You told me in the preparation, I knew that it's not so long on the market, but it's already 10 years, that's what you told me?
It's a little bit more than 10 years on the market. And
here now we also talk about optimization for high speed.
Yes, this is another option to work with higher speeds. So over the time we integrated a charge pump into this pump.
Mm-hmm.
It can only be seen if you really know this product. So it's integrated and you don't need any external charge system. And what the effect is, can you see on the right side in this graph? So the dark blue ones are the standard A15 and the light blue ones are the ones with the charge pump. So this means at the end up to 120% flow with something like 5% extra cost only.
Mm-hmm. And there's one specialty in here. You have prepared a little more information. So coming to the boost.
So coming to more details. So the principle is relatively simple. We have integrated a boost impeller. Basically, we call it impeller, and this increases the boost pressure on the suction side depending on the speed. You see what happens on this graph on the right side. So depending on the speed, the suction pressure goes up a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And this effect is basically the same what we have seen with the A4 and increasing the inlet pressure.
So it's also available for the medium range.
The effect can be compared with the turbocharger of a car.
Mm-hmm.
So so at the end you have higher speed, more flow.
Okay. Well, I like this picture from the car. Imagine to have this in my car. I'm not sure if I want that. Okay, so I think there's some more issues we have talked about. And I think we are here in the production area, even if it's now in the afternoon, it's not so loud anymore.
Mm-hmm.
But normally I think the pump is one of the noise generators in a hydraulic system. That's why I think it's very interesting how you also could reduce that significantly.
So well, I tried to get you something more general. What happens when we talk about working parameters, and there are basically two parameters which involve the noise level. One is the pressure.
Mm-hmm.
In generally, this is the picture here. We have taken a pump, whatever. The numbers might be slightly different with different pumps, but the direction is similar.
Okay.
And you see something like, in this case, something like if the red line is the more interesting one, is this full stroke, something like 3.3 decibel at 100 bar pressure increase. So there is an effect, but basically it's not that big.
Mm-hmm.
We see, and this is what we see on the next picture, this is the effects over speed. So you see in the ratio between minimum and maximum or nominal speed, you see an effect in this case something like 1.25 decibel. It might be different if you take a different pump, but
per 100 rotations, right?
Yeah, per 100 rotations. This means if you have a jump of 1000 RPM, you can easily calculate what happens.
12 decibel is not less. That's good.
Yes. You see the red arrow here. So if we talk about speed variable applications, then the target should be, with regard to the noise, to bring down the speed wherever you can.
Mm-hmm.
And you also see on the other side, if you go over the nominal speed and you exceed that, then the increase of the noise will go up drastically.
Okay.
But if this is short, only for quickly do a fast move, then it's not so important. Mm-hmm. In total, the average will be much better than with a standard hydraulic normally.
Okay. Well, I think that's still quite impressive, the possibilities here. And thanks for getting a little more into detail. We have experts here on the field, so I think they should be able to understand this.
Yeah.
So, but talking about the experts, we have questions now coming in. Mm-hmm. Finally, thanks for the questions. We felt a little bit alone right now. So is there any option for the A4 pump with an impeller? So impeller you showed with the A15.
Yeah.
What about the A4?
Well, basically you can find this for a size 750 definitely, but this is something which was made for the mobile business more. But for the let's say smaller sizes, it is not available.
Okay. And another question: is the inlet pressure the only critical parameter for speed increase?
Well, this is, I would call it, it is an important parameter.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the parameter we take here.
So the most, you would say, the most important one.
Yeah, yeah. This is, open circuit pumps have basically the problem you need to get the oil in. And mm-hmm. The more oil is flowing, the more critical it gets, and if you have some boost, it helps, especially at high speed.
Okay. Thank you for this. This looks like there's another one coming in, so we're good in time. Give us something to talk about if you want to. We have prepared a little more, but we have some time, so let's wait a second if the questions are now formalized. Okay. If it's taking some more time, maybe you can continue and we will answer the questions at the end.
Okay, coming. Okay, well, in order to summarize the small webinar of today, so we have been talking about increasing the pump speed, which means reduced size of pumps, mm-hmm. less pumps, whatever. We have seen some effects on noise, mm-hmm. which can at least to get a general idea what happens there, and we have also seen the important effects on energy saving, at least in some aspects, not in all aspects of course, and at the end of the day the machine design can be maybe made more intelligent and with very high performance.
So that's good news, that the earlier you are in the design process, you can even affect this very also cost-effective performance rate. Okay, now some more questions are coming in. Are there options for systems with HFC fluids to operate at high speeds? So alternative liquids, fluids, what about this?
Oh, this is a very special question. Well, there is basically a pump based on the A4, mm-hmm. which is able to work with HFC fluids, and this has to be checked with the parameters of the customer, what is possible and what means for him the high speed he wants to achieve.
There's another question from Steph coming in. How do you get the higher suction pressure if you don't have an impeller in the pump?
Okay. Well, there are several possibilities. One is just boost system with other pumps, or you place the reservoir a few meters higher. So every meter means roughly 0.1 bar. So if you need 1.4 bar, as we have seen in the example of the A4, you need 4 meters extra. This can be an option, or some customers use some vessel systems, they charge also with pumps.
Thanks for the sophisticated answer. Then another, what kind of condition monitoring is applicable for the pumps? We haven't talked about this today.
We haven't talked about this today, and this is maybe a topic for for another webinar. So
basically, sensors are available, need to be placed in the system.
There are some there are some development issues with sensors, and also for the HS5 there will be coming something in this direction. But these are topics which are a little bit far away from our topic.
But if there
today.
Are several specific needs, I think who was it, Pedro? He could directly place it to you or to our
And then,
colleagues.
Then we should know what is exactly the meaning behind, because if you ask people what is condition monitoring, you get many answers.
And it looks like we have another special question on the fluids. Do you have a recommendation to use HFD U fluid?
Okay. So, in general, we recommend to use FKM seals. But basically, you can use HFDU. You have to have a look on the weight of this fluid. If it's very heavy, so there might be something. But basically, you can use it in the first step.
Okay. Still, we have some more time, so let's go to some more questions. I would say 3 to 5. The speed increase will also be useful when the prime drive unit is a diesel engine. Has this been reviewed by Bosch Rexroth already? Could you answer this?
So, well, the speed increase in condition with a diesel engine, well, we know it very well from the mobile business, and also these impeller solutions with integrated charge pump are coming from the mobile originally, and we from industrial side, we take it for our purposes.
Okay. Then from Mexico, if I have a closed circuit pump to increase the motor speed, the inlet pressure is still a critical parameter to review, is the question.
Well, closed circuit is a completely different issue. Basically, you will find, if you compare that the running speed you are allowed to do with standard parameters are anyway higher. And if it's still not enough, we have to talk about it.
Okay. A specific question coming in from England. Do you have data that backs up the quoted savings for the customer presentation? So basically, he wants to get a little more information about the percentages you have shown. Is this something you can display, or you can detail maybe afterwards with a handout?
Well, details I do not have.
Okay,
but we have to discuss that with the responsible entity.
So, Chris, I would suggest to take get into contact with us, and then we can help you here for the customer presentation. I think one or two questions. Are the closed loop pumps A4 VHC are also available in higher speed classes compared to, I don't know, higher speed?
Well, there is no high speed A4 VSG because, as I stated before, the speed limit is anyway quite higher. And so the problem in parentheses is not that big.
Okay. And then let's go back to, that's now coming in very fast. What is the ideal contamination class for this pump? I think he's talking about the A15 at that, or 84 maybe, I'm not sure. So are there any information about contamination?
You find it in the data sheets. It's clearly stated what we recommend.
Coming to the data sheet, I think this is a very nice link to the next slide. Here we have prepared, or you have prepared, everything that is necessary to get the data or the information we talked about. So on the left side you see the names of the products. If you click that on the handout, you are directly linked to the catalog page. Otherwise, of course, you can search by the name of the product and have a look at our website directly. But you also have linked the data sheets for these products.
Yes.
And what I really loved that you also put in the blog post, we have now since 2 years an online blog. It's the 751 blog on our website, and here we can we have prepared in a very nice way some information on actual topics, and here we have shown three of them. So one last question: if the pump is spinning and the HS5 controller is powered off, will the pump still have 300 psi at the outlet port, or will the pressure drop to zero? Is this something you can answer in right now?
Well, spinning means, I think, turning slowly or something like that. Mm-hmm. Basically, if he combines that. if you switch off the HS5 controller, it will usually go to zero. Mm-hmm. And but you have the leakage inside the pump, and then you have your system, and this, well, the leakage of the system, we don't know. So the tendency will be that the pressure will go down.
Okay, that is coming in rotating. I'm not sure how this fits to the question. Okay. So let's give it a second. Mike is still typing.
He means spinning means rotating. Well,
okay.
Still rotating, but the normal behavior of the HS5 is to go to zero. Mm-hmm. But then you have the leakage inside the pump and maybe in the system, and so the tendency will be going down the pressure.
Okay. And now the very last question from SL Smith. Will a pressurized reservoir will be enough to obtain a higher pump inlet pressure?
This is one option, and mm-hmm. We know customers who do that in this way. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so thank you so much for these very, again, sophisticated answers. I think that's why I like to have the real experts here. Thank you for this and for giving us this information. Before you leave, I would like to give us a little more information about the upcoming webinar. We have now a brand new microsite, we call this, for the connected hydraulics system, and you just have to open up the website, the www.connected-hydraulics.com. You will get to this website, and there's one area which is called knowledge. Here you can find all the webinars that have been done in the past, but you also will find an information about the upcoming webinars. And I know, I think, early July, the 9th of July, we will show from the Rexroth plant in Chemnitz. We will broadcast live over there about standardization and digitalization for more efficiency on power units. So thanks again, Markus. Before everybody's leaving right now, I would like to urge you to give us a little feedback, how you liked this webinar, how useful it was, if your expectations have been fulfilled, and even some more comments to become better time by time. So thanks for your attendance. Thank you, Markus. Have a good time. Stay safe and tune in the next time.
Also, thank you from my side. Have a good time. Thank you once again.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.